What was maybe the difference over this past week that you kind of saw on your team?
I think, Jack, as you get closer and closer to the playoffs, which is our next game, that's a thing we've been talking about since August. And as you get closer, you can feel that it's coming. We understand that the playoffs are here and that the game is going to tighten up. It's always going to be that way as you get to the games when the most is on the line. Our first game against UConn, I really wasn't as pleased as most people might think. I didn't think we played a real clean game. We ended up scoring a bunch of goals, and I wish we would have kept a couple. But anytime you're letting in four goals like the night before, the night next, I don't think this team is going to have a ton of success. Like we have to make sure that we defend first, that we value that idea of being a hard defensive team. And when we're winning games by a goal. We know that it might be 2-1. It might be 3-2 if it's a real big game for us, but the five goal games for us are few and far between right now. We're okay with that.
You guys are staying kind of down in Southern New England this week. What was kind of the calculus behind that? And what are kind of some of the pluses and minuses to that?
Well, I would actually say it's almost all pluses. I think that when you can have the team together in one spot, we're focused. We're trying to be like road warriors, a team that is feared on the road. We haven't got there yet, but a big part of that is spending time on the road. We did some fun stuff yesterday with the team. Eric Ellens on the coaching staff, he made a big quiz game. The players had no idea. They thought they were coming in to get a meeting about the game from the day before against UConn. And I think they thought they were going to get tightened up a little bit. Instead, we kept it loose and fun. And, you know, we had 50 questions that were mostly humorous and about the coaches, about the players, spelling people's names. And it was about the campus and what's the name of the library and who the alumni are, trying to engage all these players. And then you could see actually the competitiveness come out. And that was awesome. I believe that's how teams kind of come together, is when you can do fun things together. Obviously, when you go through arduous circumstances, losing some games or being in games by a goal and almost getting there, I think that brings your team together. And then at some point you turn that around, and then it's winning a game by a goal, and then it's winning the big games. But a lot of that comes from the competitive juices, just doing fun things, competitive things against each other. And it might be a quiz show. So I think the pluses far away any negatives that are here for a team to be on the road. We planned a 10-day road trip, which would get us all the way through the tournament in Boston next weekend. And that's our only thing that we're talking about. We're not going home. We're not checking out of a hotel. We're not packing a bag on Wednesday night, because we're staying and we're planning to play on next weekend.
You guys going to be starting the postseason here against Providence. And obviously that's a team that certainly the first time you played them, you had them. You absolutely had a shot of knocking them off. And since then they've kind of seized that the rest of that game. And then the next two games you guys played against them. What are some things that they do well that you guys kind of have to be prepared for? And how do you guys kind of mentally approach this game, knowing that this is a team you had the opportunity to knock off earlier in the year?
Well, I don't remember the exact number, but it's a high percentage of their goals that they scored against us were on their power play. So that takes almost zero foresight to understand that we can't be in the penalty box. I love that we're one of, if not the least penalized team in college hockey. We work on it every day. It's the timeliness of the penalties that we take. So we're up 3-0 against Providence in that first game, and we take a 5-minute major, and it was a nonsensical penalty, had no reason to be taking that penalty. And then that gave them life. Sometimes you give teams life, and it might be blowing by their bench and grabbing your jersey, and that ticks off the rest of the team. And then they come back, which happened to us against Merrimack. You can't do that stuff. You have to respect the game, have to respect the opponent, and the momentum swings inside the game. You have to manage them. So if you're up 3-0 against a high octane powerhouse team like Providence, who's all offense, you can't give them any kind of life. That happened in the first game. The second game we played them at home, I actually really liked our game. I thought we were really good. We just couldn't score. And then we go to Providence, we play there. It's a non-event game. I rewatched the game again yesterday. The whole first half of the period, we actually dominated that period. I think they had one shot on net. It wasn't even a scoring chance. And then we take a penalty, and we take a penalty in the offensive zone, and then they score on that power play. And then that deflates us. We don't have the maturity yet to handle those. We're getting there. Our penalty kill has to be better. Of course, you have to perform. Our goaltending has to have a better penalty kill save percentage. It hasn't been good enough, but we're working towards that. The first thing you can do is not take a penalty. So that game, they had one power play. They scored on it. That game, we had, I think, 30 seconds of power play. And we didn't get any power play time that game. So we would like to play a game that's 5-on-5. I think that that is our best chance of beating Providence. I think that when we understand that we're a checking team, and that's okay. We're going to win when we check, and we check smart. We check to get the puck back. We check the same way 200 feet from our net as we do 2 feet from our net. I think that's a way that we're going to do it. Any pucks that are coming back our way, we're checking. That's the transition part of the game. If we're tracking, if we're back checking, as most people would say, coming back to get pucks and then transition, that's checking. You're checking to get the puck back. And I think that's how we're going to have success against this team. So that's the identity we need to have. It's going to be real tight in the playoffs. And I think as long as we remember our principles, our identity that we've talked about since day one, and then really believe in ourselves, and the future is right in our hands.
This tournament historically used to be kind of a three-game series sort of thing in the early rounds before they moved into their single elimination semis and finals, but now it's just single elimination. Do you feel like that kind of plays into your guys' hands a little bit, where maybe you're talking about a team in Providence that's got a little more depth, but you guys have an opportunity, if you play your best game, you have a chance to knock them off and move on?
I think when you get to the playoffs, anything can happen, right? Like, I firmly believe that all the pressure is on Providence. I think if we did a poll of anybody watching this series, or anybody watching even us talk right now, I think most people would say, I'm pretty sure Providence is going to win that. But I need our guys to understand that we actually can win this one. And if they know that, if they buy in and take ownership of our game plan, our game plans are very concise. If we do this, this gives us the best chance to win. The games that we've done that, for example, Northeastern last week, they were 100% perfect in the game plan. And we have no room for independent contractors. So the one person that takes a selfish penalty, or the one person that tries to skate the puck out of the D zone instead of moving the puck, those things, they're costly to us. Our margin of error is so thin. So we want to get to the tournament at Boston. We have to get through this game. We have to get through the weekend, travel back and play another one. That's our immediate goal. But the first goal we have to have is Wednesday night.
You guys, you mentioned that you were going through kind of Hockey East calls. Is there any kind of like all conference teams award stuff that you know about that we can announce later? Or is that?
I think they're coming. We're still in the process of actually voting. You know, you go on, you kind of campaign about your players. I'm able to talk about the players we have, I think, that are deserving. I don't think we get a lot of national attention. I don't think we get a lot of maybe even respect inside Hockey East, but that's natural. It's your own family, right? Like, you know what these players do individually every day, but it's the same thing for the 10 other teams in Hockey East. Like, they know their players the best, and they're trying to work to get those players awards. I hope people see the accomplishments of the players we have on this team and what they've done in some pretty hard circumstances. At the end of the day, awards are kind of individual, so I'm not too worried about it.
What's kind of the mentality around the team right now? How is the feeling around the group of guys, knowing kind of what's in front of them over the next couple of days?
Well, I would have said yesterday, yesterday was a day off. We're in Boston, we're in downtown Boston. We made the decision to come here, spend time together instead of going back to UVM and being on a bus there and back and there and back. At that point, we didn't know who our opponent was going to be. It turns out it's Providence, so it's right down the road. We're going to move to Providence tomorrow, practice there, and then have another practice on the game day. And I think the mood right now, Jack, it might have been a little bit tentative yesterday morning when the players woke up and didn't know what to expect when we had our meeting last night. And then Eric Ellens comes up with this fantastic idea to do this Quid Show and Max Gavin, who's our director of hockey operations, who's one of the funniest human beings I've ever met. He actually should be a game show host if it doesn't work out for him in hockey. He's like Gene Rayburn or, you know, any of the old guys who remember the game shows when I was growing up, and he's got personality and he did fun stuff. And by the end of the night, it was really light. So I think you can either be tight and tentative, or you can be loose and you can be driving. So the practice that we're going to have here in a couple hours in Boston, I think that's going to be a real important practice for us. We've structured it so they're going to have some success. It's everything that we have done before, but we need to execute it at a higher rate of success with our passes, with how we're skating, how we're moving. We don't practice for 2 hours, an hour and a half. We practice like a pro team would practice. You're under an hour and everything is at high pace, high tempo. We like our guys to talk during practice. I find a generation of players nowadays, they don't talk much. We like to have energy on our bench. We like to have energy on our practices. I think that lends to your team having a little bit more fun and really to being loose, to being driving.
Where are you guys practicing while you're in Boston?
We're going to practice at Boston College. They were just so gracious to help us. They gave us some space to even hang our equipment. We make some calls and BC, where they just said, how can we help? So that's something that down the road I'm going to remember. Jerry York is obviously a gentleman. Of course he is. And his 1 second answer of what can we do to help you guys? You're in Boston to get us ice time. Their equipment staff has been helping with our laundry on their own day off. They came in and helped us. That's a collegiality that I'm proud of. From some of the guys in Hockey East who have been really helpful. I think at the end of the day, we should treat each other professionally. We should treat each other like colleagues. There's no gamesmanship about not giving people locker rooms or giving people ice time or whatever. So when you see a man like Jerry York, who every single person in college hockey aspires to be, when you see Jerry step up and say, how can we help you guys? That's a great lesson for a young coach like myself.